Good afternoon, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, Shabbat Shalom. Now, what we're going to do today, we're going to finish up the six principles of how to love the Father. We've done the first four, and we're down to the last two, principle 5 and 6. So without further ado, we're going to jump right in and finish these up so we can move on to another topic, because there are plenty of things going on and plenty of questions that people have, and plenty of them I would like to try and answer with the Father's help. So with that, principle number 5. Now, principle number 5 is what? Being humble before the Father and other people. We have to learn humility, people. Simple as that. We have to learn how to be humble. And this falls right in line with the question that the Savior was asked. If you go with me to Matthew 18, we're going to start with verse 1. It reads, it says, "At the same time came the disciples unto Jesus, saying, Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? And Jesus called a little child unto him, and set him in the midst of them, and said, Verily I say unto you, except ye be converted, and become as little children, ye shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Whosoever therefore shall humble himself as this little child, the same is greatest in the kingdom of heaven." It's very simple, it's very clear, cut and dry. We have to humble ourselves as a little children. See, we all, as adults, we've had children, have children, or what have you, and we see them submit and humble and be humble to us, especially when we get on them with that authoritative posture and voice that we can use. So we see humility in our children, unless we just let that get out of control and then they start taking over. But we see it in our children, and that's how we need to be when we go before the Father and other people. We have to be willing to be humble like that, humble in meekness. We don't have to impress anyone here, but everyone gets caught up in their own self-desires and arrogance and all these different things and don't want to be humble. So that can be something that will cost you. Understand this, people. Humility before the Father means that all that we are and all that we have are simply a gift from Him. We are His children, and we should show Him that in our through our faith and through our trust. It also means that realizing that He has a plan for each and every one of us, and it's our job to follow the plan, not to follow our own desires and our own agendas. Each one of us has been given a unique talent, and we can and we should search and be diligent in paying attention and finding out what that talent is, at least one, some of us have more, finding out what that is to help improve our lives and the lives of others while we are here. Look, humility before other people is a quality of being courteous and respectful at all times. It doesn't matter whom it is. See, all those other characteristics of being aggressive and arrogant and boastful and all that vanity, all these things, those are just characteristics of the enemy. That's what we are always battling with. All those things are 100% opposite of what the Father wants us to be. Remember, the enemy always has a counterfeit. And we are also told here, look, we're also told that the greatest among any of us will be your servant. Go with me to Matthew 23 and 11. Matthew 23 and 11. We're going to start there. Matthew 23 verse 11. It says, "But he that is greatest among you shall be your servant, and whosoever shall exalt himself shall be abased, and he that shall humble himself shall be exalted." See, he's telling us that those who are humble are going to be the ones exalted above all. And all those arrogant and all those who think they're this, that, and the other, they're going to be the ones pushed down in the end. Remember all those characteristics of the enemy, they're going to be done away with. So all those walking around with their chests all puffed out, these arrogant attitudes, those who never humble themselves to the Father and fall into His will, they're going to be put to the wayside when it's all said and done. Remember, the Savior came here from heaven to be our servant. He humbled Himself to the point of being our servant. To do what? To save us, to give us all an opportunity. And now look, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? He is. See, He humbled Himself. Everything about His life is an illustration of what our lives can be. So we really have to pay attention and jump on board and let go of these things of the world that hold us back from doing any and everything that is right. So one of the questions can be is, how should we or how are we to deal with people of different faiths and different beliefs? The Father has called on us simply to spread the word. We're not called on to impose our faith, beliefs, or our values on others. We're simply called on to spread His word. Let Him do all the work that He said He's going to do. Let Him touch who He's going to touch. Don't go around trying to impose anything on anyone. Everyone has free will. So be humble in passing forth that message and allow it to do whatever it's going to do to whom it's going to do anything to. Being humble means focusing more on the Father rather than ourselves. We have to focus on Him and not ourselves. Humility does not in any way deny us our own self-worth. See, people don't want to be humble because they don't feel like they're worth anything when they're being humble. They feel like everyone's stepping on them and walking over them, and they just feel worthless. And that's farthest from the truth. That's a lie of the enemy, because like the word says, those that will humble themselves will be the greatest in the kingdom. So it's up to you to choose to make the sacrifice if you're willing to be humble here and suffer, if that means suffering whatever it is, to make it to the kingdom. For me, it's worth it. So we also have to understand that, you know, all these different successes, wealth, power, status gain at the expense of others will only bring us anxiety and pain and drama, and it will never bring peace and love. You can look around this world and see all these successful this, all these accolades that, all this, and so many of them have nothing short of drama, destruction, disaster, whatever going on in their lives. It's not worth it to a strong degree. It's a big risk. So, next we're going to move on to principle number 6, our last principle. And this one is one of the most important. We have to make time for prayer. We must realize how good the Father is to us, and we must be willing to get on our knees and thank Him and commune and talk to Him about this. So, principle number 6, making time for prayer. Okay, go with me to Matthew 7. Matthew 7, and we're going to start with verse 7. Matthew 7, verse 7. And it reads, "Ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. Or what man is there of you whom if his son ask bread, will give him a stone? Or if he ask a fish, will give him a serpent?" Verse 11, "If ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your Father, which is in heaven, give good things to them that ask Him?" Who wouldn't give their own child what they ask? If he asks for a fish, will you give him a serpent? If he asks for an apple, will you give him a stick? If people who are evil know how to give good gifts, all he's simply saying is, how much more will the Father in heaven give His children, His obedient children? Now, speaking of prayer, has brought to mind a prayer request that I received. And there is a small part that I want to read and expound upon that, because prayer is very important. And this is where we all need to be in times of pain and anguish, so that we don't lose our faith and trust in the Father. And this is where people seem to tend to lack the strength, because they don't stick faithfully to the prayer and have patience in allowing the Father to do what he's going to do in his time, not ours. It says that, however, my faith is being greatly tested, so much so that I find myself in a fit of sadness for days on end. Now, that to me is very telling, because people get into these areas of problems and sorrow and things going on in their lives to where they feel like this is endless, and these types of things lead to depression and what have you. People get into this sadness and misery, and they wallow in it because they feel they have no way out of it. Look, I'm here to tell you that praying to the Father and being faithful and diligent and trusting in him is one of the most peaceful things we can do. Look, here are some areas that we need to focus on when we pray to the Father. And then after all that said and done, we need to be patient and let it rest with him. We need to stop carrying these burdens. And I'm going to read them off right quick. Expression of faith and trust in the Father. Worship and adoration of the Father. Confession of our sins. These are some of the things we need to be doing when we pray to the Father. And they may all not apply at the same time when we're praying, but these are some of the areas that we need to think about and focus on. Praise of the Father's mighty deeds. We need to get on our knees every day and thank the Father for every little thing that he does. Now, you don't have to try and think of every little thing, because you never will. But believe you me, for every breath you're allowed to take, the Father has done something to allow that to be. The enemy is after us 24/7. And for us to survive 24/7, the Father is at work protecting us for whatever reason and for whatever cause. And we need to thank him for that. We need to show thanksgiving for all the good things, like I just said, that we have received. We have to show our dedication to serve others. We have to be willing to serve others. It is not a selfish life, people. This life that we have is to be shared with others for the good. That's why it's important that we find out what our particular gifts are that we've been blessed with to share with mankind to improve their lives and ours. And request for needs and the needs of others. So we also have to be able to do that. Request for the needs of ourselves and others to the Father. We have to be doing a work for mankind. So the Father promises to answer our prayers. He says he will answer our prayers. But understand this. We have to be wise in our prayers. He is not going to answer our prayers that are foolish or ridiculous. We may not get the answer that we're subscribing to in our own mind when we request things of the Father. He answers them in his own way, in his own time. We have to be persistent in prayer, but we don't have to be redundant. Understand what I'm saying? We don't have to keep praying for the same thing over, over, and over. You don't like it when your child comes to you and asks you for something, and you say, wait a minute. They come back a minute later. Wait a minute. And finally you say, I heard you the first time. We're no different. The Father hears us the first time. Give it to him and let it be. So, I'm not going to drag this out. There's just so much more that we can talk about. But prayer is so important, people. Pray to the Father. Show him thanks. Show him the love. Show him the respect for all that he has done. But most importantly, show patience. He has given us many promises, and he keeps his promises. We have to learn how to be patient. It's in his time, and it's the way he sees fit that's best for us. We have a small window to view out of. He has the whole world that he can see. With that being said, remember, this is Brother Lloyd. Be faithful and listen to the Father and his word. I'm out.